we're here with Joe Pavlo, the director of Downsizer, which is seen today at the opening night of the Edinburgh Short Film Festival. So hello Joe, thanks for coming along.
Hi.
Downsizer's action comedy about office politics. How did you come to make that film?
Myself and a couple of other guys actually got made redundant in our jobs, totally independent of each other, and we all decided we needed to make a film that was like just sort of have a laugh and a little bit of violence and a lot of violence and a high body count just to get it out of our system.
Well, yeah. It resonates quite a lot with the selection committee and also a lot of the audience. I mean, did you have any idea about how difficult it was to make that? I mean, there's a lot of CGI in it as well, and just the action sequences. How long did it take to make that, and shooting it and so on?
Well, we shot it over a couple of weekends, and my day job is visual effects supervisor, so I kind of know what I'm doing in that area. I like to think I do, and it was just a matter of chipping away at the visual effects one at a time with a couple of other fellow artists, and got it through. You know, kind of approached it with eyes wide open, but you know, wanted to do the things. I guess the whole thing took a lot longer than I had hoped for because life kind of got in the way.
Oh yeah,
I could probably have finished it in a couple of months if that was my job, but with the day job and the family and stuff, it took me a couple of years actually. So,
all right, okay. So, I mean, you know, given the nature of the storylines about the management of a big company trying to kill off their employees, and it's kind of like a die-hard comedy kind of thing. So, I mean, given the nature of that, did you get a lot of support? So, you filmed it in a big office block.
Yeah.
I mean, was that difficult to get the access to office, given the nature of the film? You know, we don't want to make management to be bad guys, you know. Was there any of that, or did you find it very easy to get cooperation down in London?
Surprisingly not, no. I mean, it was actually shot in two separate locations. One in the city of London, which has those amazing views out the window, and the other one was in Canary Wharf, at another office that had a big open plan office thing. And both places had a good look at the script and didn't seem to have any problem. And I kept going, are you sure? Is this, you know, are you sure? You know, they were like, yeah.
Because okay. I mean, the management were really nasty in this. They were sort of real sort of Bond villain type guys, aren't they?
Yes and no. I mean, I see the management as like almost paralyzed with fear throughout the whole thing. And you know, but yeah, it comes out nasty. Yeah.
So what was the hardest sequence to shoot? I mean, there's lots of stuff going on. You know, what was the most difficult bit to get quite just right, you know, in terms of the action sequence?
The big atrium sequence where the character appears again. You think she's dead. She appears again, and that was probably the most difficult because it was a huge space, and it was getting late in the day, and we were running out of time. But we had a death scene in there that was meaningful and stuff like that, and so it was a matter of trying to budget the time properly and do it. And my lead actor Ed Coleman actually forced me to reshoot something a couple more times because very cleverly, because he said I'm not quite comfortable with that. I was ready to move on, and he goes, I'm not sure that was quite yet, and I said, okay, let's do it. And I was like, and it forced me to stop and think for a second and kind of appreciate the fact that this is important. We got to do this properly, so rather than rush things. So that was the hardest one. That was the hardest one. It was complex and large and pressured.
I really loved the guy who had this homemade samurai outfit.
Yeah.
That was brilliant. I mean, was that a difficult prop set to get together? I mean, you sort of used a waste paper bin, and it was all very sort of almost a lamp on Keith Robinson kind of construction there.
Yeah. Well, the whole idea is that you have the human resources, which are all tooled up with armor and guns and weaponry, and the office staff, which are trying to weaponize their office equipment.
Yeah.
And so I had the idea of doing some sort of armor, you know, and then a samurai kind of came to mind as a wizard. And that character is kind of the artistic sort of element or the creative element of the office. You know, he's the one who's drawing the pictures. He's the one who creates this sort of beautiful armor out of you know, office equipment and stuff like that. So.
Great. So what are you doing after this then? What's the next step after
Downsizer? Well, I'm going to be very, very busy up until Christmas working on Disney's Jungle Book during the day, which is going to completely swallow all my time for the next couple of months.
You've got a background in visual effects, haven't you?
Yeah.
So you do the visual effects for this?
Yeah. And in that one particularly, I'm focused on supervising the stereo 3D aspect of the visual effects.
Oh, well, that'll keep you busy then.
Yeah, so I'm not going to be able to do anything until then, but I'm going to try and keep writing, and I'm working on an animated feature, developing an animated feature with a friend who's written a children's book, and then I'm writing a script based on my own experiences, moving to London 30 years ago in a noisy art punk band.
Really?
So, yes.
What were they called?
That's another story. That's another interview.
What were they called?
The hamsters.
Oh, no, I don't have the hamsters. I'm sure. Joe, thanks very much for coming along. Thanks for letting us see your film. And all the best for the future.
Thank you very much.
That's all.
Cheers.